Actually, the mic might be easier. Let's see if you can hear me on this. Turn the volume up some. Yeah, me too. I've been playing with it, you know, before without the hard drive, but it's kind of nice now to have one. Yeah, thanks for popping by for a moment. I also just got a dug through and found an ISA sound card, and I finally found a game that actually has ad lib support. That's what I was just playing a moment ago, the Super Off-Road, and I've got that working. So we've even got some ad lib sound. Hello, Ricardo. Again, hopefully you can hear me okay. Oh yeah, sounds like you can. All right. Yeah, have a good one, Josh. Should hook up a keyboard or a joystick. But oh. very touchy on that. There we go. I think that'll work. Oh, no. Hello, Nintendo Wolf. Welcome to the stream. I'm just installing some of my old DOS stuff. Got a 286 set up here that I just got an XT-IDE adapter put together the other day, installed yesterday, and set up like a hard drive with a 2 gig partition. Have DOS 622 on it, and I've just got like some old floppies that I've had forever, back when I used a DOS-based computer a lot more, so just installing some of that. Yeah, I mean, I lucked up on this one. It was a flea market find for like $10, so can't argue with that. What I've really been chasing myself is getting as close to the old 8088 processor, at least for the speed, because I've still got like a few really old DOS games that are tied to the clock speed of the processor. So this gets as close, especially when I turn off or turn on turbo, whichever way that it goes. I think it gets down to, I want to say like 8 megahertz or 10, something like that, which plays those games fairly playable. So not right now. Okay, let's do the others. Oh yeah, 1,000. Yeah, I'd really like to get one of those. There was a 1,000. I don't know if it was the SX or which. It was one of the desktop models that was set up at one of the past VCF East events, and they had a version of SimCity running on it, and I remember sitting down and spending a little bit of time playing that. Definitely love the version of CGA graphics that computer has, and the sound. Oh, that's fun. I think the SideQuest, that's a removable, isn't it? It's kind of like the zips or something to that effect, right? Yeah, I could see that being super nice. Just another easy way to have different setups. Definitely, I guess definitely for like a 1,000, because I assume you're still, that would also be fighting with the maximum of what, like 640 or 768 K of RAM, something like that, 720 K of RAM maximum, something to that effect, unless you've got some kind of mod going above that. So I could see, depending on the games, like having even some different drives set up just to do the memory management. Man, I really liked Zone 66 back in the day. Let's see here. Whoa. A lot of files. Let's try it like this. x86 or better. Oh, man. Okay, so this one won't run on a 286. Okay. Remember. Alright, next. Although I swear I played this Zone 66 on a 286 back in the day. It's probably like some kind of a. Nope, requires 386, 46 or faster. Okay, maybe I didn't. Okay, well, no problem. Plenty of others. Alright, let's see. Yeah, 640. So I guess there can be times, depending on what you're trying to play on it, where you have to fight for every little. Every last K just to get a few of the programs to load up. Let's see here. Next. Any particular favorites that you like to play on it or load up, or is it just something you kind of turn on every once in a while? Hey, this is coming out of my sound card. Nice. this game might be pushing the 286 a little bit to its limit as well. It's got a combo of sound card, I guess like ad lib music and PC sounds. That's too funny. Aha! There's jump. Is on or off. I think it's. Give me the magic. I think this is kind of hitting the maximum of what this poor 286 can do. This would probably definitely benefit from extra power of, like, say, a 386. But hey, at least it tried. Yeah, I mean, if the game, that game may or may not be tied to the clock speed, though, so you may not even need to do that. The clocking usually only comes into play if it is, like, hard tied to the clock. See how fast. fast this is going to run. There we go. See, this is almost playable. Let's see, number three, number four. So, I want to do this. Oh, I played this so much as a kid. Now, let's see. It's Q. Phaser. Okay. I think I can get the gist of it, maybe. Ooh. Oh, God. Ooh. Okay. Oh. Yes, I believe so. I believe that's correct. So this even runs a little too fast to play. I mean, I could get faster and better at it. Oh, computer's deciding to run into the. So also, if I can remember, one of these. One of the buttons also lets you rebalance your energy and shields. Let's see. Shield energy C. Okay, that's what it is. Oh no, ran into it. Yeah, I would highly recommend it. I played the absolute crap out of this as a kid. I loved this game so much. But I was playing it on like an 8088, so I would say that it ran, it was a lot more playable at those speeds. Fantastic. Dark. Oh yeah, I mean, obviously there's far quicker, easier ways to do some of this, but you know, there's a little bit of the act of putting the floppy disk in the drive, doing the copying, kind of waiting for things to happen. It's just a little bit part of the experience, I think. Sometimes I'm more in a hurry and, you know, use some other method, but I like going through some of these too, because some of the games are just not, they're can't always find like the exact version, it feels like, sometimes online of some of these that I had. Some of these boot. Let's see, will this run from? Yeah, I think I can. Yeah, I don't know how common certain containers are for this sort of thing. And this one, at one of the last I think the July swap meet, I got that whole box of discs and a bunch more, because the guy was basically just sort of wanting rid of it all at once, so just kind of kept. I showed some interest in a few things, and he's just like, here, take this, take this, take this. So ended up coming home with like 2-3 boxes of floppies like this. All right, let's see. Curious if this will run. Some of these you just about need like a hacked version, because even if you copy the files to the drive, it just does not want to run. Do you have a mouse? Yes. You want music? Of course. Let's see. Let's go with an adlib. Yeah, I don't blame you. It's, I'm trying to, you know, I'm not purposely going out and trying to collect a whole bunch of floppy disks. Like I said, it was one of those things where there was, you know, a number of, like, actual labeled original game disks that this guy had, and it's just like, well, how much for these? And then it just became the same price just to take all of the game discs. At first we were just going to flip, or I was going to flip through and just, you know, take a few titles that were of particular interest, but he just really wanted to offload, so probably had the same idea, wanting to cut down on the amount of stuff he was sitting on. Oh, interesting. So the mouse, you can just move. Huh. Okay. exit the game, though. Always the thing when you don't have the manual, trying to figure out how to get out of the game. But I think this is one of those that expects you to just sort of boot, and when you're done, just cut off the computer, not really drop back down into a DOS environment. Oh, yeah. I know. Yeah, I'm not doing too bad on that, but I did buy one of the local Goodwill stores had like a, I don't know, like a 12 pack of sealed VHS tapes, and I did grab some of those, but thankfully I had somebody that wanted to take half of them, so I didn't have to hold on or store quite as many, but you know, it's always nice to have just a few, if nothing else, because I mean, I still have a VCR that I sometimes mess with, have a few VHS tapes just for the fun of it. You know, it's just something sometimes to just put in, as long as it's like a movie or something that I would watch over and over, that sort of thing. I like having a few VHS cassettes for that. This game disc is a little bit iffy. Let's try again. Oh, never mind. I'm trying to read. Dirt. Okay, that all looks good. Yeah, I think a lot of the games that the 5 1/4 games that are in this particular box, I believe most of them sort of expect to just boot straight from the disc and have protection on them to keep you from just copying to a hard drive and loading. Yeah, well, you reach a point where, I mean, everybody's sort of offloaded, you know, packs of VHS or the recorders or what have you that they had sitting around in a basement, or, you know, a relative has passed away and that's been cleaned out. I mean, it's no different than, like, what we're seeing with a, let's see. I guess, well, we'll see if that works. But I guess it's no different than some of the retro game systems. When you think about it, I mean, a lot of people have already cleared out their basements and stuff, so you get down to where it's there's less and less and less of that, so what is out there starts to get more expensive, I guess. CD. Let's just try Doom, maybe. Maybe Startup. Let's try that. Don't know if this card does EGA or not. Let's just do CGA. Faster PCs. Let's let's try high. Oh Lord. It's good old. I don't know. Let's go with two. Hey! His main weapon is... Well, I don't know. Wrong. Dang it. I'd have to look up the manual for this. Well, we'll do that another time. Yeah, it just varies. You know, there's still, I mean, there's still plenty of good deals to be found. It's just, you know, there was a point where I can remember back in the, like, say, the early 2000s when I could still walk in, say, a Goodwill, and I found, like, bags of, like, say, NES controllers and hookups and stuff, and it'd be like a few bucks and walk out of the store with those, or like just cartridge games for the systems would show up, and again it'd just be like something you get for a dollar. Now, nothing super rare, mind you, but I mean, like, you'd see a lot of good titles like that. I mean, I've even got like a GameCube that later on was there, and I think I got it for cheap as well, maybe. I mean, for at the time, I want to say that maybe it was like $5 or $10, something like that. Just things like that. Now, I mean, it depends on the area you're in. Here where I'm at, the stores are picked over pretty good, so it's exceedingly rare to walk in like a Goodwill or similar type of stores these days and just find stuff like that. And if you do, you know, what I'm seeing is really high prices, because nowadays too, Goodwill looks up a lot of things online, and prices a lot of times what I think is a pretty crazy price. So but then sometimes you wander in and you do find something retro or really neat for next to nothing. I mean, you can certainly still walk in, there's stacks of like say at least DVD players. I mean, it used to be, until just very recently, I mean, if you wanted like a good gaming CRT, you could walk in and pick those things up and I mean, they were like 10, 20 bucks for like giant, good brand name televisions. So they don't seem to get those quite as much now. But every once in a while, you'll still see one. So there's things to find. But I think for now, that's going to be it. You know, I got a few things in. Just wanted to test some copying over. I'll probably do another one of these. I need to dig out one of my controllers that I have, because I do have the game port on the back for that. So I want to test that out a little more, and probably go through. I need to fish out a few more discs and games, that sort of stuff, and set that up. But really appreciate you hanging out here, Nintendo Luke Wolf. Good talking with you and such. So hopefully you'll be able to join at a later one as well. Yeah, anytime. It's something I'm just kind of playing with. I'm not like huge on the streaming type stuff, but it seems like sometimes it's fun. People like to watch or hang out a little bit and see. So, and it's a way that I can kind of record what I'm doing. So, but anyway, have a great rest of your day, and I'll, you know, we'll do this again sometime. Thanks.